They are two powerful and extreme forces of nature. Sharks and volcanoes. And the mystery is, where you find volcanoes.
Oh, we got one!
You'll find sharks.
This is just incredible.
Across the globe, volcanoes are like magnets for sharks. There are 500 active volcanoes on the planet, causing earthquakes, spewing lava, and wreaking havoc. We steer clear of them. While sharks are attracted to volcanoes, even active ones, like moths to a flame. Galapagos sharks can grow up to 12 feet. They can be bold and aggressive, so Mike and Kirk have to keep them in sight at all times.
With this many sharks here, we gotta be careful, and we also have to watch their behavior. If we see them hunching their backs and putting their pectoral fins down, it means they're not happy, and we're gonna have to get out.
20 sharks becomes 30. They're surrounded. And then, even more sharks emerge from the depths. A large tiger shark could never get in and out of these tight volcanic alleys. And that's figured into the survival strategy of one of their prey.
Look, yeah, look, there you can just see the top of it spinning.
White-tipped reef sharks. This species is one of the few that can pump water through their gills and lie motionless.
Look at this, right there.
One of the sharks bolts. Agitated, it rushes towards Mike and cameraman Duncan Brake, looking for a way out. Luckily, the shark wants no part of the dive team and swims clear. As Mike explores the deeper crevices, he finds more hiding sharks. They seem to be sleeping, even though their eyes are open.
That's exactly where I'd be if I was a sleeping white-tipped reef shark. You can see the shark wants to stay here, you know, out of that swell that this team gives them. So one of the things about the relationship between volcanoes and sharks, these tubes and
fins
create spots that are attractive to sharks.
Rangiroa is a volcano on its deathbed, but Mike discovers it's completely alive with sharks.
And you can also see that there's a lot of reproduction going on here, not just from the pups, but you see bites on a lot of the big animals here. That's not from predators. Those are the females that have been bitten by males during mating.
Rangiroa attracts large schools of adult sharks. But where are they coming from? Are they swimming from across the Pacific, or are they locals? Could this dead volcano be a shark nursery? The team identifies a prime spot for baby sharks, a shallow patch of water called Blue Lagoon. With its sandy, shallow bottom, it has all the elements black-tipped shark pups need to survive.
This is just incredible. I mean, we got, what, at least 11, 12 sharks here from a few days old to a couple years old.
If they ventured into deeper water, these baby sharks would be eaten by larger sharks.
Hello, newborn.
Oh, newborn here, yeah.
Mike and Jeremy want to grab blood samples from the young blacktips.
We'll get the blood plasma and the red blood cells that we can use to look at the genetics so we can figure out, are there brothers and sisters out here? You know, how many females are coming to have their pups in this area? Why don't you grab the fish and try to get them focused on that, and I'll see if I'm fast enough to grab one.
No rod, reel, or net.
Ah, dang it.
Mike will try to catch a shark with his bare hands. Ready for blood?
Yeah.
Oh, it is definitely not easy to get blood from a shark this small. Yeah, the vein's really small. Ah, perfect. Good job. That blood will give us an idea of how quickly they're able to start foraging on their own instead of relying on the energy they got when they were pups.
In Polynesian mythology, the goddess Pele ruled volcanoes, and Kamoho Ali'i was the shark god. They were brother and sister, and ruled the land and the sea. Today, sharks and volcanoes still reign over their oceanic world. Extreme forces, forever joined.